Right now, mental health is considered a separate and unequal system of care because of our prejudice against people who are suffering from a brain illness. Nothing else. We need to treat people with human dignity in spite of their skin color, their gender, their sexual orientation, or their mental health. The foundation of what we considered a modern America was really built on the sacrifices of so many, including Dr. David Satcher, who is not only a civil rights leader, but a medical doctor, a CDC, Centers for Disease Control director, and Surgeon General of the United States. Indeed, it's a huge honor to have him leading this new medical civil rights movement. I'm proud that we are embarking on the Kennedy Satcher Center in Atlanta, Georgia, because I think this is a movement that can take a page from that civil rights movement about how to get social change on every level.
Let me just say how very pleased I am and proud, really, to have the Kennedy Satcher Center. It's a tremendous opportunity for us to really contribute to an area to which we're really deeply committed. It just brings to the forefront all that I care about and I have been caring about for many years, since my early days in Atlanta doing the student sit-in movement. Our goal is to bring parity of access to mental health services, quality mental health services. We're excited about it. We have some good people. Glenda Wren, she's exceptional. She cares about people and making sure that patients get quality care.
I think that this issue of how do we treat individuals with mental health and substance use disorders, are we able to give them dignity and respect, which includes giving them treatments that they deserve and high quality care, is going to be something that over time we'll look back and we'll wonder, well, what did you do during that period of time? Were you part of the solution or did you just stand by aimlessly? And we're going to change the system to meet the needs of the patient. That's where I think real transformative change is possible.
If we create a new normal, then future generations will not grow up with the same prejudices which dismisses people with these illnesses as less than. We need social change not only on a societal level, we need it on the personal level, which is what the civil rights movement was really based upon.